Internal trait features, characteristics of internal trait. What are the characteristics are there, or what are the features are there for the internal trait? What is the meaning of internal trait? The buying and selling of goods and services that will be done within the country itself only. It will be the internal trade. That the internal trade is also called as domestic trade, also called as home trade. So now the features. What are the features are there for the internal trade? First one, the selling and buying. Selling of goods or buying of goods within the boundaries of the same country, not by the one or more countries, only in single country itself. Buying will be there and selling also will be there. So that's what here, the first feature of the internal trade is what? The goods and services which may be sold or buy, that may be taken place within the boundaries of the single nation or same country. This is the first feature we have to maintain. While we say it become the internal trade, means that the buying and selling will be done within the country. Second, the payments are made by the purchaser. Payments are made by the purchaser to the seller. Purchaser to the seller in the home country in domestic currency only. There is only the one currency that may be relating to one country itself only. So if you may buy the product, you become the purchaser. Some other person sell the product, you become the seller. Seller will get the money from the buyer, which is the domestic only, that too in domestic currency only. There is no involvement of other country currencies at all. That will be another way. But here what I have to say here, the currency will be involvement within the country of one single currency, one country currency only, exchanging while we are buying the goods and selling the goods. In return, we may pay the currency of domestic only. That is the second feature. Only few formalities are required while you are trading. Trading means buying and selling of goods and services in terms of money or money worth. We can say with the exchange of money or money worth, you are buying and we are selling the particular products. The purpose, there is no involvement of moving forward to other country, or from other country you may take away, bring the goods from the other country, like that. There is no happening here, only within the boundary only. So that there is not at all problem that the currency not goes to out, our products also not goes to out. Within the circulated area only we exchanging it, so that some sort of requirements legally, we can say few formalities you have to required for doing the internal trade. If you want to trade your products in domestic level only, so that for not the more and more formality, there is a less formalities will be there. That is also another future of internal trade. Nextly, the futures of products are well known to the customers. See here, clearly knows about the products, goods which are needed to the customers. Customers are clearly known about the futures, known about the futures of particular product. That will be done only in the internal trade only. Clear futures, you have to observe it. You want it, then you can buy it. That should be done within the country itself only. You may try to observe, you may go within the country itself, anywhere place where it is available, you can go there only. Then you can identify what are the futures will be there, and then you can clearly know it, then only you can buy it. If you want to buy in other country product, you can't know the futures. You may assume it, you may observe in over internet through only, not directly go and observe it. That is not possible. Where it is possible, in our internal trade only it is possible. With that, what happened, the clear information regarding futures of particular product will be known by the customers. It is also another feature. Nextly, a risk is more because of changes in demand from widely spread located in domestic markets. In our domestic market, various places we have a lot of markets. So our products may be go to sale in different markets. So some sort of places have more demand, some sort of places have less demand. Whenever the less demand will be there, then automatically our products are not able to sell within the country. So there is a problem of particular demand situations. That is another future. There is a risk is more. There is a risk is more compared to foreign country, foreign trade, the risk is less only, but here also we have the risk. How the way we are facing the risk is the demand changes in demand because of various locations we have in domestic markets, various places we have a lot of markets, different market places we have. So there is a demand will be affected, automatically we have to face the risk. So another future is what? Compulsory risk. There is no risk at all in internet trade, it is wrong. We have the some sort of risk compared to other type of trade. That is another feature. Risk is more because of changes in demand from the widely spread located domestic markets. Nextly, the influence of political, legal, social and cultural and economical environment of the country is less compared to foreign trade. If you do the internal trade, there is no maximum effect by, there is no maximum effect, there is a minimum effect only will be there. It will influence it. What are that? Like political situations or legal formalities also, and cultural activities point of view, economical environment also. In particular country itself, the affection will be the influence will be the very and very less only compared to foreign trade. If you do the foreign trade, there is a lot of influences will be there. These all will influence more while you are doing the foreign trade. But in our home trade or internal trade, these are the activities may not influence it. It may be influenced less only. That is what we have another future of the internal trade. Whereas the next one, the goods are manufactured according to the requirements of the domestic customers. They may not getting the specifications received from the buyers also. Means here what happened? The goods which are manufactured according to requirement of the domestic customers only. Domestic customers only. In our domestic itself, we are the customers of direct relations. So directly we knows who the particular customer, they want which type of product, what are the features he want it. Like that it will be clearly known by the manufacturer, retailer or wholesaler. With that through only they are manufacturing the goods. So there is no need to observe the requirement clear. So here what next, no specifications are received from the buyer. I want this type of product, I want this type of product, so that information not giving to the manufacturers by the customer. If you do the foreign trade, compulsory I want this type of product only. If you produce it, you can produce, I will be pay the money. Like that information taken over from the customer, and that through information they are manufacturing it, and those will be exporting it, we are importing it. So that is not done in internal trade. So that only the another future is what? The manufacturers are preparing a requirement of domestic customer. Who the domestic customers are there, how they want to take the product, that the way only the customers will be producing, manufacturers will be producing. So there is no specifications will be receives from the buyer. Manufacturers can't get the specifications received from the buyers. May not get the requirement, what type of product they want it. Like that, they may not taking the information from the buyers, which is not required. Finally, for physical flow of goods done between the manufacturers and customers, that may be in domestic transportation system only. Domestic transportation system through only the goods may be physical movement from the manufacturers to consumers. That is done only the domestic transportation system, like roadways, especially railways, like that we have to see. This is what we have the features of the internal trade. What are that? Firstly, selling and buying will be done within the boundaries of the country. Secondly, payments are made through one country currency through only, and formalities will be the Features of product well known by the customers, clearly known about the product, and risk is more because of the changes in the demand in various marketplaces in our India itself, and influencing of political, legal, economical, social may be less compared to foreign trade, and goods are manufactured according to requirements of the customers, which are domestic customers only, and the manufacturer may not get the specifications received from the buyers. Buyers may not be giving the requirements to the manufacturers. And finally, the physical flow of the goods from the manufacturer to customers done with the domestic system transportation, domestic transport system through only, the goods may be forwarded from the manufacturer to customers. This is what we have the features of the internal or domestic trade. This is what we have the topic.